Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we have an M140i having a Wavetrac diff fitted, and we also have our friend here, Hamza, who this car belongs to. Yeah. How are you doing?
Not bad, how about yourself?
Yeah, very good, thank you. Yeah. Nice journey from sunny Birmingham.
Yeah, it's a lovely place to come from, isn't it? Birmingham to Luton.
Birmingham to Luton.
I know, perfect two places to travel between.
Living the dream.
Yeah.
So anyway, so you have bought this M140i and we're doing a project with you.
Yeah.
So far we've done the stage one map.
Yep.
Which you're really enjoying. If you want to check that video out,
yeah, we'll have a link.
You can go over that. And so what are we doing today?
We're fitting a Wavetrac LSD to the car. So as you guys know, this car comes with an open diff as standard, unless you bought one with an LSD, of course. But yeah, that's one of the main kind of drawbacks or kind of weak points of the car, isn't it?
Yeah, so that's my kind of impression of it as well, because M cars all come with limited differentials. So when I get into a M-Lite or a non-M car like this, the engine's fantastic. They're just missing something on the chassis.
Yeah.
A little bit, and especially when you're used to a limited slip diff, having open diff, just feels like you've been cheated.
It's almost like deliberately held back, isn't it? Yeah. So, I mean, they're a fantastic package for the money. The fact that you get an inline six in a hatchback, rear-wheel drive. But yeah, it leaves a lot of room for improvement. That's, of course, the reason why we're doing this project, just to show what you can do with this platform.
Yeah, so we're also going to then tackle the suspension and then more power with the pure 800,
The pure 800 turbo.
So that should be a lot of fun. So I'm actually looking forward to experience a Wavetrac on this car myself, because I haven't. We have had it on other cars like our E39 M5 and our Mini.
Yeah.
On the Mini, it made a huge difference, obviously, because it's front-wheel drive. So I'm looking forward to see what this is like. So guys, this video is going to be just a bit of the installation and then my driving impressions of the car with the Wavetrac fitted. If you want to watch a bit more detail about the installation and what makes a Wavetrac different, we'll put a link up here so you can check out Hamza's channel, and please subscribe to his channel as well. Wavetrac's been fitted, so let's go and see what all the fuss is about. I have experienced a Wavetrac diff before in our Mini, which made an absolutely huge difference, and also the E39 M5. I went immediately, even going in a straight line. You can feel the diff fighting to keep the car in a straight line. The traction light is flicking a lot less than it normally would. Let's get around this corner. Yeah, you can just feel it. It just wants to propel you out of the corner, whereas before it would really struggle. That's made a huge difference. So I'm used to driving M cars, and when I go into an M-Lite, that is the one thing I really do miss. It's the limited slip differential. This does feel much more M2 like now? So this road's quite bumpy. We'll do like a little bit of a launch. I'll switch the hazards off. Yeah, you can feel it. It just wants to keep it as straight as possible. That's a massive improvement over stock. And when people say this is the best modification you can do on one of these, they are not hyping it. It is actually one of those cases where the hype is real. So that's with the traction fully on. Now go into traction mode so we can feel what that's like. So you can actually hear the wheels spinning now when it's losing traction, but it just keeps the car going forward. Yeah, that's a lot more playful now. I remember this car is on stock suspension. The bushes have made a huge difference as well. One of the gripes I have with these cars is almost like the rear subframe doesn't feel connected with the car. I feel much more connected with what the rear of the car is doing now. But the one negative thing about that is it's really highlighted the poor connection in the front a little bit more, whereas before it was slightly more balanced. But Hamza is planning on doing the M4 lower control arms on this, so that should... Whoa! That's a hell of a lot of fun, honestly. If you've got one of these, I think that is definitely a must-have modification. Yeah, just there, coming out of that corner, it was just... Road slightly bumpy, put your foot down, whereas normally one wheel would completely lose traction. It just catapults straight out of it. That is really, really cool. So we're not going to talk too much about the technical differences between an ATB and this Wavetrac diff. We have done that before with Ash, and he's actually made his own video on the M140i, so we'll link that above. Also, Hamza's made his own video with his driving impressions. We'll also link that so you can take a look. But I think this car now is a really good base for him going forward and putting more power in a car, because I think without the diff, that would really be a bit of a waste. And he's not all about straight line speed. He does like his corners and enjoys driving. And I think that's what the diff mod is all about. As much as straight line speed is fun, and yes, we go to VMAX, we do actually like driving the cars and enjoying corners. And the Wavetrac diff is absolutely perfect for that. And the other thing the Wavetrac lets you do is this. Thank you for watching, guys. If you want to watch more of our videos, you can watch them over here. If you want to watch what YouTube suggests that you might like from our videos, you can watch them over here. As always, if you haven't already, please like our video and subscribe to our channel. If you've got any questions for us, please drop them in the comments below and we will do our best to answer them for you.